Dear comrades, first of all, I salute you all for this august presence. The hall is full and a lot of people are standing. And in Delhi to have a hall full, I know how difficult it is. I congratulate Comrade Devashish Ghosh, Comrade Ravindra Gupta, Comrade S.S. Prasad and other leaders who are here. Comrades, I would like to just make 3 points. First of all, this idea of merger of 3 banks, we know the origin, you all know how we started from the Narasimham Committee. But the last effort was done by the Finance Ministry using the Chairman of State Bank of India. Mr. Rajneesh Kumar was asked to make a presentation to the MDs of all other banks. In the presence of the Finance Minister who was officiating, Mr. Piyush Goyal, in which he had argued that the merger of associate banks with State Bank of India was a great success, which is an utter lie. State Bank of India, for the first time in the history of more than 200 years, made loss in its balance sheet for the first time after this merger. The non-performing assets in 2017 increased to 1,17,000 crores, and by 2018 it reached 1,35,000 crores. And in 2008, the last 2 quarter results which have been out, further losses are increasing. The Finance Minister had made a statement that there will not be any retrenchment of people. Well, there was no retrenchment, but there was a VRS scheme in which around 4,000 people left. And the recruitment has been reduced. The net reduction in the staff has come down by 15,000. Number of branches which have been merged or closed is more than 600. Administrative offices more than 100. So there is a reduction in number of branches, reduction in number of staff, which is not being told to the people. The bank is actually bleeding. And in all probabilities, this government will be happy to privatize State Bank of India first. Last week, I was attending another meeting here where Dr. Prabhat Patnaik was making a statement. There is a pressure from the United States of America. The senators have been coming and representing to the government of India that at least as a tokenist measure, you privatize the biggest public sector first in this country. Which is the biggest public sector? Bank? State Bank of India. And some stories were floated that State Bank of India is going to be one among the top 50. Fine, what does it matter? And one among the top 50, you compare it with the top first or second bank, you are minuscule. The biggest banks are Chinese banks now. At one point of time, it was Dutch bank. You compare the total balance sheet of a Chinese bank with the State Bank of India after the amalgamation, it is almost 1/20th of those banks. So what difference you are going to make in a global market? And as told by Dr. C.P. Chandrasekhar, there is no formula that bigger banks will survive better. The 2008 crisis have proved again and again that it was the biggest banks which were failing for the first. So this argument that merger will help to revive the banking sector is totally flawed. Number two, we should have confidence in ourselves. I am glad that AIBOC is organizing this meeting along with CFA. And it is AIBOC along with CFA which is responsible for throwing the FRDIB bill to the dustbin. Nobody ever thought that this mighty government, when a bill is being introduced, you can see that it is shelved. Nobody had confidence. I am glad that Comrade Ranjan was saying that this issue should be an UFBU issue. The merger issue has to be taken more strong by the UFBU. In the FRDI bill issue, when we wanted to take up the bill, there were people within UFBU itself who were saying that what can we do? This is a very powerful government. They will introduce the bill, they will get it passed. At the most we can issue a press statement, that's all, what more we can do. But we did not leave it. The same thing what we tried in the FRDI bill, we have to try now. That time me, Sunil and Ravindra Gupta, together we went and met Mr. Rahul Gandhi. We met D. Raja. We met Comrade Sitaram Yechury. We met Mr. Sharat Yadav. I met along with our Orissa comrades, Mr. Naveen Patnaik. I met with our Kerala comrades, Mr. Pinarayi Vijayan, Chief Minister of Kerala. Like that, we started approaching every political party seeking support that somehow this bill has to be shelved. And all of them assured support. They raised the issue in the parliament. When it went to the Joint Parliamentary Committee, the Joint Parliamentary Committee chairman did not want to meet me. When I approached him through a BJP supported office bearer, what he told was, my direction is that within December the bill has to be passed. What is the use of Franco coming and meeting me? I cannot make any changes. The bill will get passed. We did not leave it. We went to the Joint Parliamentary Committee, made our presentation. We had a signature campaign. Like this seminar in Delhi itself, we organized 3 seminars. All over the country, we organized at least 15 to 20 seminars. We had a massive signature campaign. People, NewsClick came to support. My interview to NewsClick, it went viral. People started looking at it and there was withdrawal taking place from the banks. Then the government got the notice that this is going to be dangerous, there is no other way, they withdrew the bill. The same way this merger issue has to be taken to the people. I am glad that Comrade Soumya Datta has given a slogan, go to the people, connect with the people. Now, I'll tell you a small story about having a contact and connection. One Swami Vivekananda, when he had gone to Chicago for giving that famous Chicago speech, he was traveling and he was being interviewed by a journalist. He had just given another lecture and he was coming, and that time he had talked about having a connection and contact. This journalist was asking, what is the difference? Both are same. Then Swami asked a question. When did you meet your father last? He said, 2 years back. When did you meet your family members? 2 years back during the that year's Christmas. How long you had been sitting and talking with your father? He said, hardly a few minutes. In the dinner table we were talking for some time. How many times you have been sitting with your children and taking care of them, talking to them? He said, very seldom, because I am a busy person. Then Swami told him, you have contact with your family, you don't have connection. You require that connectivity. That is what Soumya has given an appeal to us. That have that connectivity with the membership, have connectivity with our customers. That is a very large following we have. Let us go to the people and tell them what is happening to this country. What will happen because of this merger? Whether these banks will ever be able to improve their performance, it is not possible. Dena Bank, now we are saying that it is a bad bank. Who made it bad? It is this Reserve Bank of India which is responsible. Can any bank survive without giving loan? Under prompt corrective action, they put a condition that you can accept deposits but you cannot give loan. Anybody with common sense will understand. Without giving loan, what is banking? The definition of banking itself is accepting deposit and giving loan. And you are putting an embargo on giving loan and you want them to perform. So it was made to show more and more loss. And that is the condition at which now today they are talking about merger. They were trying to create a situation to show to the people that they are not doing well, they are not doing well, then we don't have capital, so only way is to merge. And then after merger, what will happen? Same thing what was told by Narasimha, same thing what was told by PJ Nayak, that now privatize. Yeah. So that is what is the agenda. So comrades, now our duty is to see that we go to the people. We tell the people what is wrong with this government's policies, all that NPA, IBC, now RBI is fighting with finance ministry, it is all shadow boxing. I am telling you today, Urjit Patel is not going to resign. He is a man of IMF, he is a man of Reliance, he is not going to resign. They will do some shadow boxing. But they are together killing the banking sector. November 8th, 2 years of demonetization will be over. Recall the speech made by the Prime Minister of the country. I am just asking for 50 days. I am asking the people who are honest in this country to stand with me for 50 days. After 50 days, the honest people all will enjoy, they will be happy. And all dishonest people will start running away, they will go behind the bars. All that kaladan black money will come back. Where is the black money? They are still searching. So it is time to tell him that 50 days is over long time back. Now it is time you go back. Unless we change the policies of the government, we cannot save the public sector. We cannot save the public sector banks. So let us fight together. Let us go to the people, common man, the farmers. Farmers are going to have an agitation in Delhi on 29th and 30th. 1 lakh farmers. Let us stand with them. Let us stand with the majority of the people in this country and continue our struggle. I am 100% confident that this merger will not take place and we will succeed in our struggles. Thank you, comrades.